Hey guys, it's Hannah and this is Bookworms Talk, and today I'm going to be reviewing Spanish Love Deception by Elena Armas. I rated this book 2 stars. I know. Bring the pitchforks and the fires and stakes and shit. I will talk about what was good about it, what was bad about it, but first I'm going to give you a summary. After a humiliating breakup, Catalina moves from her homeland of Spain to New York to work as an engineer. With her sister's wedding around the corner, she's desperate for a plus one to ward off the pitiful looks from her family and friends. Enter her co-worker Aaron. They originally get off on the wrong foot, but then he offers to go with her and pretends to be her boyfriend. So it's a fake dating trope. There are a few reasons why this book didn't work as a whole for me, and most of it comes down to the writing. And I mean this in not a way to sound cruel, but the writing was very clunky. It felt like it needed to go through a few more drafts. I just remember there being long paragraphs broken off. Forget the technical word for this, but they're the long slashes. And I mean, it'd be like lines and lines of a whole paragraph. So much to the point where I would then have to go back and reread the paragraph before the break to understand how the two connected. And I just feel like it could have been simplified. And it just felt clunky and over-explanatory, and there was a lot that could have been deleted. It was a big book, and it didn't need to be a big book. So that's my main sticking point. And I also didn't particularly feel fond of the characters. They didn't feel well-rounded, and they didn't feel very, like, realistic. They felt like a caricature. I just was not a fan. I thought this was gonna be, and maybe this is my own fault, I loved the movie The Wedding Date back, I think it was early 2000s that came out. I loved the shit out of that movie. And I guess maybe I went into it with a similar expectation, and so maybe that's what let me down. And also the fact that everyone hyped this book up, and I feel like I'm in the minority for not liking it, but whatever. Sorry, my camera cut off. So referencing my notes, the pace could have cut out 100 pages easy. I'm really searching for something positive, and you know what else? Maybe it's a me thing. Everyone said this book was like really angsty and that they connected with the characters. And I'm like, what happened? Did not get any of that. And I angsty love angsty books, and I didn't even get a whiff of it. And maybe it's because Aaron as a character, I felt like, I don't want to use the word lazy because I feel like that's too harsh, but I feel like the simple approach, the easier approach, was taken in saying like, oh, like Superman, just like him, just like Clark, that's just who he is. It felt like there was no building of him done as his own character, not as a caricature, you know what I mean? Hope that makes sense. I get how some people like this, but it just wasn't for me. It didn't tick the boxes. It didn't deliver what was promised. I literally was searching my notes for something positive, and genuinely, I didn't write a single positive thing down while reading this. Was it the worst ever? No, but when I was like 30% in, I regretted buying it. So I think 2 stars was generous. I think maybe 1.5 would have been more appropriate for this. So that is about all. I'm sorry this was super negative. I know I do these occasionally, and depending on when I upload the other video, maybe kind of back-to-back-ish. Hopefully I'll throw a positive one in there between. But it is what it is. It just wasn't for me. If you liked it, I'm glad you liked it. I didn't even really talk about spoilers here. There wasn't a ton plot-wise that really happened at all anyway, so I felt like there wasn't much to spoil. You kind of got it all just from knowing that this is a romance book and reading the back. You know what I mean? I feel like I've said you know what I mean so many times in this video, I'm sorry. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you next time.